This is the SR-71 Blackbird, one of the most high-performance aircraft ever built. I set out in KSP-2 to build my own version, even better than the original. But we have one small issue. Kerbin is quite a bit smaller than Earth, and the numbers don't exactly go one-to-one. So we need to set out some ground rules for our measurements between the real-life aircraft and the aircraft you can build in KSP-2. First, we can easily compare velocity between these two aircraft as, well, speed doesn't really change on our measurement scale since they both use meters between the two planets. So, what are the numbers of the SR-71? Well, that's just a nice casual speed of 3,529 kilometers per hour. Or approximately Mach 3.3, or for the comparison for KSP, since we operate in meters per second, that's 980 meters per second. That is the top speed recorded by the SR-71. It is estimated it could go a bit faster, but that's the highest they ever got on record. Next, we need to compare our sustained flight height. This is the maximum height that the aircraft can fly horizontally, sustained under its own power, not counting any orbital shenanigans or busting out of the atmosphere with enough thrust. And this is where things get a little more complicated, because Kerbin's density of atmosphere, while at the surface, is equivalent to Earth, it operates on a much different scale than our real-world planet. So we have to basically make some comparisons based on air density at various heights compared to the flight heights of other real-world aircraft. To start, we'll look at a standard commercial airliner. Those operate in the real world around 10 kilometers in the air. This density on Kerbin equates to approximately 7 to 8 kilometers. This is pretty comparable in height, all things considered, but it is a pretty significant difference when you're talking about the scale of planets here. And then we need to look at the flight height of the SR-71. At a staggering 25,929 meters, just shy of the 26 kilometer mark. Again, we compare the air density at that height on Earth to the air density equivalent on Kerbin, and that puts us roughly around 18 kilometers. So now we know that we need to travel at least 980 meters per second and sustain our flight over 18 kilometers to beat the SR-71. And, you know, maybe we keep the Kerbals alive. So let's see the plane and its test flight and see how it goes.
Thank you.